Hello, friends, and welcome back to Stories About Entitled People. I swear, I'm not the apartment manager. This happened quite a few years ago, but another post on the sub made me remember it. I used to live in an apartment complex that had multiple buildings on the same street. The building had a foyer that anyone could enter from the outside, but you had to be buzzed in from a wall phone in one of the apartments to actually get into the building. I was in apartment number 19. The apartment manager was in the building next door, also in apartment number 19. There was a sign hanging in the foyer indicating how to get a hold of the manager, but unsurprisingly, people only skimmed over reading it and would call my apartment instead of going next door. The sign was very clear that the manager was not in this building. People are just bad at reading. A little irritating, but generally not a big deal. Except for this one time. I was sleeping. It was 1 in the morning and the wall phone rang. I definitely wasn't expecting anyone. Me. Hello? Him. I'm here for my appointment? Me. If you're looking for the apartment manager, you need to go to the building next door. Him. No, we schedule our appointment for this morning. Me. I'm not the apartment manager. You need to go next door. Him. I came all the way out here. I want to see this apartment. Me. Go next door. Call apartment 19 in that building. I'm not the apartment manager. I can't help you. And I hung up. Of course, he called again. Me. What now? Him. I just want to see the apartment. Is it available or not? Me. I am not the manager. You need to go next door. Him. Well, the sign here says you're the manager. Me. The sign says that the manager is in the building next door. He starts mumbling as he reads the sign out loud to himself. I hang up the phone again. Of course, he calls back. Me. Jesus Christ, what now? Him. It says the apartment manager's in number 19. Me. It says they're in number 19 in the building next door. Go over there. Him. But how do I get there? Me. Walk. It's literally next door. Him. Can you call a cab for me? Me. No, I'm not calling you a cab to take you to the building next door. Stop calling my apartment. He tried calling again, twice. I stopped answering the phone. I have no idea if he ever found his way next door or not. And our second story. I don't work here anymore. So this happened a few months ago, and friend said I should post it when I was telling the story the other day. I used to work for a large bargain chain in the UK. I hated it. I liked the people I worked with and a few of the managers, but the company and the majority of the customers were, slash, are just awful. The pay was rubbish, and the way the company treated us was crap, but I needed a job. As you know, I like to eat and pay my bills. So I stuck it out for a few years while applying for other jobs, and finally the gods saw fit to get me a better job out of retail. I've been working in my new job for over a year now, but I still go into my old work because A, I like to catch up with the people I like who still work there, and B, I love a good bargain. Now, on to our story. I was pushing my trolley around, just browsing shelves, when I heard a cough behind me. I ignored it and continued on my way. Then I hear an, "Excuse me." I continued to ignore it, as it wasn't really a voice I recognized, and it doesn't have anything to do with me. Then comes the sharp tap on the shoulder and the louder, "Excuse me." I turn around and see a former regular customer. She was always a nightmare and was one of the many reasons I was glad to get out of retail. She'll be NC for nightmare customer. I will be me and FM will be former manager. Me. I beg your pardon? NC. Don't think you can ignore me. I want you to get me XXX. Me. Sorry, I don't work here. NC. Yes, you do. I've seen you behind the tills. You served me last week. Me. No, I didn't. I used to work here, but I haven't in nearly a year, so I don't work here. Get someone else to help you. NC. Well, you're here now, so you can help me. Me. Nope. NC. What do you mean, no? Me. I don't work here. Now kindly piss off and let me finish my shopping. NC. You can't talk to me like that. I'll have you sacked. Where's your manager? Me. No effing idea. And I walked off while she was screeching like a banshee and finished my shopping. So I get to the tills and I'm loading my shopping onto the belt, chatting to my former manager when she comes charging over and starts yelling. NC. You! Pointing at me. I want her sacked! Pointing at me. She was rude and swore at me. FM. Sorry, ma'am. I can't fire her. She doesn't work here. NC. Don't you lie to me. I know she works here. FM. No, she doesn't. She used to, but she left for another job. NC. Shut up. She swore at me and was rude, so you need to sack her. FM. Can't sack her. She's a customer. Me. I don't work here. NC. This is ridiculous. I want the manager. FM. I am the manager, and she does not work here. Me. Nope. I'm free. I'm also leaving. Bye, FM. FM. Bye, redheads. NC. Why is she leaving? Me. Because I effing can, you belligerent old bat. And I pushed my trolley out of the shop and went on with my day. Next time I went in, my FM had a story to tell me. Apparently, NC was so awful after I left. She swore, she threw things, she generally behaved like a toddler, throwing a massive tantrum, that the deputy manager banned her from the store. So FM has said that if I see any other nightmare customers, to see if I can rile them up into getting banned. I said I make no promises. Entitled Woman at Universal Studios. I'm a 24-year-old female working in Osaka, Japan. Naoko, a work friend, invited me to Universal Studios Japan. I agreed because they have owls. Live, adorable, real owls at their Harry Potter adventure, which the United States does not have. Naoko is nervous to go see them because she doesn't like big birds. I want to go, so I'm asking her nicely to come with or wait for me to see them. While we are discussing this, someone taps me on the shoulder. I turn around and see a well-dressed mother and her 11-year-old daughter. They look pretty normal. The mother, Karen, is wearing a Harry Potter shirt, carrying several bags, and looking lost. Her daughter is begging to go on a ride. Karen pulls out a map and says, "Hey, you speak English? I can't figure out where whatever ride is." I point in the general direction we came from. I tell her, "I do. We just came from the ride over there." Karen taps the map with a perfectly manicured talon. "But where specifically?" Naoko pops in because she is the most helpful person in the world. I'm not being sarcastic. She is wonderful. "You have a pen?" she asks me, miming drawing on the map. "I always have pens on me," I tell her. "Here, if you want, she'll circle it for you." Karen looks like I threatened to carve out her child's eyes and feed it to Izanami for breakfast. She jerks the sacred map to her chest and tells me, "Do not touch our map. Just take us there." Naoko, like the little kid from The Sixth Sense, just whispers dramatically, "We see owls." I can see how annoyed Karen is getting. I'm very thankful that Karen has made Naoko more interested in seeing the majestic sky cats. Anything, I think, is better than being around Karen. So I tell Karen that, unfortunately, the F's have left the building and they will not return this season due to budget cuts in the F account. I tell her, politely as I can, "We're going to see the owls. Just ask one of the workers. We found a couple of people who speak really good English." Naoko and I are off to see the wizard, and Karen says loudly, "Just take us to the ride!" Me, "Nope, we have to go now." Karen, "My daughter is going to be really upset if we don't get to the ride before closing." Me, "Talk to an employee, ma'am. I'm not a tour guide." Karen, "But you're American." Me, "So? I live here now." Karen, "So you should help me." Me, "No thanks. Have a nice day." Karen then turns to her daughter and tells her that I am not going to show them where the ride is, so they won't be able to do it before daddy finds them. This 11-year-old girl proceeds to fall onto the ground and start sobbing. Karen, "Don't make a scene!" Freaking out. So this girl's throwing an absolute silent fit, pounding on the ground with her hands, all while not making any noise. Naoko and I decide we're going to leave. Karen's just standing there while we leave, telling her daughter we ruined the day. Instead, you know, of asking these super bilingual employees. It was so weird. And our next story. Lady, I work for the police, not Target. So it's like 5 a.m. and I'm drunk and I wanted to share this story. A few months back, I worked as a police dispatcher. We were required to dress in business casual, so khakis and a button-down or polo. I'm assuming you've read the title and see where this is going. So after work one day, the girlfriend and I stopped by Target on the way home to grab a few things. I'm wearing, you guessed it, red polo with khaki pants. I also have an ID badge on my belt denoting communicator, Joe Schmo, police department. Grabbed some olive oil, brought to my girlfriend who told me she got some a few days ago, so back to the olive oil aisle I go and put it back. I put it in its proper place because I'm not an inconsiderate a-hole. Anywho, lady comes up to me and asks if she can find some brand dog food. I thought she was just asking for my opinion, so I gave her a general direction. She went off on her way. Like 5 minutes later, I was looking at Harry's razors, and I felt someone poke me on my shoulder. I turn around and find the lady standing there, looking displeased. Lady, my dog food wasn't where you said it was. Me, well, I don't know. Go ask someone who works here. Lady, I am you. Me, nope, don't work here. Then I turn and look away. Yes, you do. You were stocking shelves. Me, yeah, don't talk to me. Lady grabbed my arm and pulled me to face her. You ever get a sudden flare of anger? I did. B-word touched me. Lady, young man, I'm a customer and you'd better... Me, don't you effing touch me. My voice was a little raised now. Touch me again, you and I are going to have a problem. She was obviously taken aback. She said something about me being fired and a manager. She scurried away, and I found my girlfriend, and we went to check out. At this point, it still hadn't really clicked that she thought I worked there. I just thought she was rude. So we get to the self-checkout, and the lady with a Target employee approached me and my girlfriend. Lady, that's him. That's your stock boy who threatened me. Me, WTF, I don't work here, lady. Leave me the F alone. Manager, looking non-pleased, you don't work here. Me, nope, this chick started bothering me, then grabbed me. Girlfriend, he doesn't work here. Lady, don't you lie to me. You were stocking shelves and told me where to get dog food. Me, leave me alone or we're going to have real problems. Lady, how about I call the police and tell them how you just threatened me. Me, I effing dare you. I showed her my ID badge. Let's see how that works out for you. I should mention the police department I work for is in the same town as Target. So the manager takes the opportunity and just says, have a nice evening, and motions the woman away, and she follows. She just sort of gaped at me when she saw that I was in fact not an employee of Target, but the police department she was going to call on me. Not a big story with fireworks, but still one to tell. Moral, beware wearing red polos, and stay thirsty, my friends. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video to the end, and I'll see you in the next one.